Guys, welcome back to the Paper Whisperer. I know it's been a while, but I want to celebrate since my Praying Mantis video hit over 100 views. So I designed a version 2. So this is the crease pattern. Feel free to take a look. I'll zoom in. Basically, there's a Pythagorean theorem in theorem or whatever. There's another one here, and here for the and then. There's some precincts, some pointy things, I don't know. So let's get started. This is, by the way, I will not be showing a pre-creasing part of this tutorial, just the collapsing and shaping. And I'll try to remember, I might forget to put a crease pattern link in the description. Okay, now let's get started. Anyways, let me move this aside. So we'll start by collapsing this part. Which is the simplest part in my opinion. Which is the first part of our Pythagorean theorem extravaganza. A bit of a cold, I'm sorry if I have, if it sounds like I'm a bit scratchy. Basically, you do a normal precinct. This is off of a 32 by 32 grid. Now we're going to repeat this part over here. Using 7 sheet of Kami and I wouldn't do a tutorial. I didn't say that much earlier. So now what we're gonna do, we are gonna make this new crease actually. What we're gonna do is we are gonna fold, we're basically gonna fold this so that it collapses flat and clean. Two legs here at the praying mantis. And we will work on this part a bit. I'm going to push this part in. And we're going to repeat the whole thing on this side. So we're going to do the reverse. The reverse, whatever it's called, the Pythagorean theorem. She knows this is a super complex model. So if you don't want to get frustrated and you're a beginner, I would highly, highly, highly not recommend this. Now comes the fun part. What we're gonna do is we are gonna take this part and push it in. Same over here. Makes this layer go up and go back down. I showed that clear enough. Show it again. We do a zoom in. Basically, push this part in, and this part in, and it makes this go down. Super simple. Not really. And then repeat twice more, actually. Not three more times, that'd be awful. Too many pleats for the end, for the back end of the praying mantis. Extend these creases. And do the Pythagorean theorem once again. gonna do is you're gonna make a few more pieces. What we're gonna do is we can work on this part now. We're gonna do some more clever heat sink. On the other side. It's gonna look quite weird now. We're just gonna keep collapsing. Trust me, it's gonna work out. I think. So, our praying mantis beast is basically harassed, lol. Get it? Basically, beast. Anyways, so, that was a bad joke by me. So, now what we're gonna do is we are actually gonna open this part up. And push in the middle. Makes it a bit flatter. Now we're going to push. Now we're going to start shaping. We're going to push the neck together. And what we're going to do now is we're going to make the arms. Or the legs, or whatever they're called, when you, the parts that you see praying. And then we're going to finish by shaping off the legs, and then we'll make the wings. Actually, no, we're not going to make the wings. This is a different type of praying mantis. But it doesn't have wings, let's put it that way. And push it all together. And make the shell. Even though there's no shell, it just makes the back of it. I should say, there's not really a shell in praying mantises. That'd be weird. Whereas they need a much, much, much more mysterious creature. Now we're gonna turn it over so that its belly is up, facing up, or its stomach, whatever, its abdomen, whatever you want to call it. I'm pretty sure it's not the abdomen, that's part of the body, or a section. But anyways, we're basically gonna make it white side up. But I meant to tell you, you want to start color side up if you want the, you want the green praying mantis, or colored praying mantis. If you want a white one, I'd recommend just using the white paper. It's a complete waste of another color. Is not a duo-colored model. Well, I hope you had a great day, or you're having a great day so far. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial, and I'll see you next time. This is what it looks like, by the way. Bye. Have a great day.